So let's talk about presentations. From your bedroom, home office, on Zoom or Google Meet, in the classroom, lecture room or boardroom, we either give them or we receive them, and some of you have sat in some that have made you fall asleep. We can all agree that presentations at the best of times can be super boring and draining, especially when the host is trying to keep your attention by moving a tiny laser pointer or cursor around the screen. Now, if you're like me and you wear glasses and have terrible eyesight, it's like trying to find a needle in a haystack. You've got absolutely no chance. All of that is why the team here at Swiftpoint have created the presenter and virtual meeting software for our range of pen and vertical grip mice. This is a set of tools that enhances your ability to perform presentations using your PC, either in person or remotely via screen sharing apps. And in this video, I want to showcase how they work across our range of mice in the air and on the desk. So let me begin by sharing which of our mice work both in the air and on the desk. That will be ProPoint, SurfacePoint, and TrackPoint. These three mice also work as an in-air presenter as they have a built-in gyroscope, whereas the rest of our pen grip range, including ErgoPoint, our vertical grip mouse, only have access to the virtual presenter, which is called Virtual Meeting. So how do you use the virtual meeting tools? Great question, and let's dive in. First and foremost, by default, when opening any of the major video call and screen sharing platforms like Zoom, Google Meet, Teams, Skype, Microsoft PowerPoint, and Google Slides, the desktop presenter toolbar will automatically appear on the side of the screen, and it will look exactly like this. And so as you can see here on my screen, we have the toolbar. Now, to move the toolbar around, simply just click and press on the SwiftPoint logo at the top of the toolbar, and you can move this around your screen wherever you would like it to go. Now, by default, it will pop up over here in the far right-hand side of your screen, so it's nicely tucked out of the way so it's not overtaking your screen. And then, as you can see, we've got multiple different icons. We've got a cursor, we have the spotlight icon, the laser pointer icon, we've got the highlighter and or the pen tool, we've got a text tool, we've got a magnifier glass, the eraser, we've got the clear all, screenshot, settings, and exit. Now, what do all of these do? First and foremost, beginning with the cursor or the pointer, pretty self-explanatory there. It just allows you to go back so that you can use your cursor. We also, then the second one down is the spotlight. And as you can see here, it brings up the virtual spotlight tool on my screen. So we can move our mouse around and have it act exactly like a spotlight presenter would do. So we can highlight certain parts of our screen, certain parts of our slide. And the second and or the third option is the laser pointer. And then as you can see here, you click on the laser pointer and it will bring up the laser. I've customized mine just slightly, but I'll jump into that in just a second here on this video. But that's what it says on the tin. You can move around your cursor that also has a laser pointer, drawing extra attention to the particular point that you are speaking to during your presentation or your video call. And then the next option is the highlighter. Once again, does what it says on the tin, will highlight certain parts of your screen. So you can click and drag underneath some words and do some highlighting. You can also draw circles to highlight a certain part of the presentation, draw shapes, however you like. And once again, you can fully customize that, fully customize the color and the size, but we'll jump into that shortly. And so then to get rid of your highlighter, or the lines that you've drawn, or the certain arrows and shapes that you've drawn, you can come back over to the toolbar and click clear all, and that will completely clear all of the additions that you have on your screen there. And then we have the text tool, of course, does what it says on the tin again. You can click and then you can type on the screen. You can add some little messages to your viewers and be like, keep an eye on this part of the presentation. Just to add a nice little touch there for the people that are looking, and or you just once again wanting to raise a bit more awareness to that particular part of the slide or the presentation that you were talking to. And so then once again, to get rid of the text that you've added to the screen, just come over and click on clear all. And then once again, that's completely gone and your screen has reverted back to normal. And then the last feature, well, the second to last feature on the toolbar is the magnifier. Now you can click on that and as you can see here, it will magnify certain parts of the presentation for you. So once again, you can really draw attention. Let me go to a different slide here. Once again, you can really draw attention to what it is that you are showcasing on your screen to your viewers, either in the room with you or online through the virtual meeting settings, which is what this bit is right here. And so then to revert back to your cursor, simply come back over to the Swiftpoint toolbar and click on the cursor icon, and then you have reverted back to your cursor or your computer pointer. And so we had the eraser tool. Of course, as you can see here, it comes up with the little eraser icon, but this, of course, will only work if you've used either the highlighter or the text tool. So I can show you how that works. If we just want to highlight this heading here, maybe a little highlight underneath there, and maybe we'll circle the pro point down here in the corner. If we didn't want to clear everything on the screen, we just wanted to clear one thing, we could come in, get the eraser, and just click on there, and it will erase that particular point or shape or line or highlight that you have made on your screen for you. And then jumping into the very last feature of the toolbar, that is the screenshot tool. Now this is a fantastic tool because there's multiple times maybe in a meeting or just throughout the day when you forget what the keyboard command is to take a screenshot. I work between Apple and Windows, as you can see here. So I most of the time forget what keyboard commands are which when it comes to a screenshot. So being able to just real quick and simply come over to the Swiftpoint toolbar and click on screenshot and grab a complete screenshot of my screen and be able to save that, even better. Super helpful for me, super quick as well. And one thing, one extra bit that I would like to add onto that is if you have highlighted certain parts of your presentation or your slide and you've maybe added some text in there as well, and it's like important text, let's just type in here, pay attention to this slide. And in the meeting, one of your colleagues or a friend or a family member, whatever it is you're presenting, has said, that's a really great point, can you send that to me? Or, hey, need to make a real quick note of that. Then what you can do is with all of your highlights and all of your text still on the screen, you can hit the screenshot button and then that will save everything that you have put onto your screen, including your highlights, including the text and the annotation that you have put onto your screen and over the top of your slide. Super fantastic feature, great tool, is a lifesaver for those moments, as I mentioned, where you're talking through your presentation or your slide, you've raised a good point, a coworker has raised a good point, you've noted it down, you want to send it off to the team, or you're celebrating a certain win and you've added some extra cool little funky text and emojis or other things in there, then you can do that, take a screenshot, put it into your work chat, bang. Super fast, super easy, fantastic feature, and I love it. And so if you are using an unsupported program but would still like to use the presenter tools, then you can launch it by manually going into the P3 control panel and enabling it under presenter, desktop presenter, and clicking enabled. Or right click the Swiftpoint icon on the control panel's system tray and click enable desktop presenter. If you would prefer the desktop presenter not to open automatically, this feature can be disabled for specific apps or entirely from this screen as well. This can be found under auto launch and clicking on the disabled option. So to activate the gyroscope and presenter mode inside of ProPoint, Surface Point, or Track Point, you need to flip the mouse over and flick the switch into present mode. When switching to present mode, the mouse is now ready to be used as a handheld remote for in-air presenting. You can also customize the tap and hold functions for all three buttons to better suit your workflow, but by default, they are set to the following. Begins with front button tap is next slide and left click. Front button hold is laser pointer. Center tap, next previous slide and up. Center button hold is spot point. Rear button tap is previous slide and up. Rear button hold is the magnifier. And so to show you what this looks like in action, I've got my monitor here with a couple of unofficial Swiftpoint slides open. We are working here within Google Slides, and I'm going to quickly switch my mouse again over into present mode. So if I press and hold my left click button, so the front button, that will bring up my laser pointer. And as you can see here, I'm just moving it around as freely as I can whilst it's in my hand, highlighting certain parts. of the screen to showcase to you guys and to showcase to the people that you're talking to. If I press and hold my second button, then of course, as you can see here, this will bring up my spotlight presenter, which is pretty cool. You can see as well, the screen around the spotlight will go dark, so that you are able to truly showcase and draw people's attention to the position of the presentation that you want their attention to be drawn to. And then if I press and hold the third button on my ProPoint, this will bring up my magnifier. And as you can see, it does what it says on the tin. You can use this to magnify certain parts of your screen to once again, really get your viewers' attention. And so I'm now full screen in my presentation, and I'd like to show you how easy it is to flick back and forth between your slides in the full screen mode of Google Slides using the buttons of my ProPoint mouse. So I simply just press the left click button and this will move me forward a slide. As mentioned, these are unofficial SwiftPoint slides, so there's no information on here, it's just a load of text and words. And then if I keep clicking through, of course, it will allow me to just keep going through all of the different parts of my slides. It will also activate the animations that you have as well built into it. And yeah, it's just super easy to do this whilst you're in the boardroom, classroom, and online in any type of meaning. Okay, so the next part to showcase to you guys is how easy it is to customize all of the buttons and the functions within the P3 control panel for the in-air presenter and the virtual meeting software. So when you come in to your P3 control panel and click on presenter, you will be working with the screen here. And as I mentioned already in the video, it showcases what the default options are on all of the buttons for the in-air presenter mode when you've clicked on presenter and under button functions. And of course, as mentioned as well, you can customize all of those to better suit your workflow to be able to activate the certain features that you enjoy the most super quick whilst you are presenting. And then if we come over to Spotlight, then we've got background dim and spot point size. We can, as you saw when I had my Spotlight presenter out, it was dark around the edge and then it was nice and bright where the actual Spotlight was. Then we can click on this and as you can see, it will darken the screen to show you how dark it can go and also how light it can go as well. Once again, customizable, so it's up to you how dark you'd like your screen to go. I usually have mine probably at about 3/4 because then it's a real easy and nice way for people to truly be able to see what it is that you are showcasing and talking to, no matter if you are in the boardroom, lecture room, or online on a Zoom or Google Meet call. You can also change the size of the spot point presenter. You can make it real small like this, or you can make it super big like this. Somewhere in the middle for me is cool, but once again, customizable for you and your workflow and your style. So I'll keep mine within the middle here. And then we go over to the laser pointer. So as you saw, my laser pointer was a ring, and how you get the ring is that you can get it towards the middle and it will turn into a ring. And the larger you go, the bigger that ring will become and the thicker the outside will be. If you go smaller, then it does turn into a so-called proper laser pointer that you would most likely be used to seeing. And once again, we can come down to laser thickness and we can change that around. So this is more so for if you were like me and having it set as a ring like this. So if I come here and slide it down to smaller, then it'll become a nice small size ring, or all the way up here and it can become larger, and you can actually make it a solid laser pointer if you wanted to have it that big. You can have it as big as that, but probably not gonna be the best option and probably don't recommend that too much, because otherwise then you're actually covering up what it is that you are trying to showcase. And underneath there, you've got color. So you can change the color of your laser pointer to better suit you and your needs and or your style that you have within your computer and your workflow. Could also be quite cool to try and maybe find the color that's more suited to your brand as well. If you're working for a company or you've got a personal brand, then you can grab the slider and try and find the color that is more suited to your brand. And coming over to magnifier, same again, we can make the magnifier larger. We can also make it smaller, so it's a smaller little window, almost turns into like a vertical kind of phone format, which is quite cool. I leave mine once again halfway, and then we've got magnify heights. We can change the size, we can make it quite thin like a rectangle, or make it relatively quite large, almost like a vertical kind of phone, which is really cool. Slide that back to the middle, and magnification level, so we can either have this to just magnify just a little bit, or we can really zoom in up to 5 times and get that really zoomed in. Once again, being able to draw the attention of your viewers to the point that you are trying to make in your presentation. So if we jump out of those and come in to virtual meeting, it is relatively all the same customization across the spotlight, the laser, the magnifier, and the highlighter tools. But I will really quickly run through these with you guys. And so as we can see, we've got virtual meeting toolbar enabled or disabled. We've got mirror mode. You actually have a video on mirror mode already on our YouTube, which I will link down below for you guys. And if I'm able to, I'll link it to a card somewhere up here in the top left or top right. I'm not sure if YouTube will allow us to do that just yet, but I'll figure it out. Auto launch enabled or disabled, which means for when you automatically launch your video software or PowerPoint or Google Slides, etc., then it will automatically bring up the toolbar for you. I've already covered these, but we'll just quickly click on them again so you can see them for the purposes of this video. Make your screen darker, draw more attention into the spotlight, and then the spotlight size, smaller, larger. Same again for the laser pointer, all of the same customization, larger, smaller, laser thickness, smaller, larger, and then the color. The magnifier, same again. You can go small on the magnifier, you can go large on the magnifier, magnifier height, magnifier level as well. I'm gonna actually bring this down because it's a little bit too much for me. 2.5 looks good. And then here on the virtual meeting, we've got the highlighter, which we don't have on the presenter, but on the virtual meeting, we do have the highlighter because as I showed in the video, we can draw on the screen. And we can change the size of the highlighter here. So real small, almost disappeared, or large as well. And highlighter transparency, make it darker, or we can make it light there too. And we can also change the color using the slider. Now I like blue, so I'm gonna put mine to blue, maybe make that a bit darker. And there we go. That is how you customize the presenter and the virtual meeting options and spotlight, laser pointer, highlighter, magnifier within the Swiftpoint P3 control panel. And so there we have it, everyone. There is a in-depth overview of the presenter and virtual meeting tools within the Swiftpoint P3 control panel for your pen grip and vertical mice. Now, if you have any other questions about any of the stuff that has been covered here in this video, please drop a comment down below. If you like this feature and you use this feature, we would love to hear from you. So please also drop a comment down below. I'd love to hear about it. I'd love to talk to you about it and get the conversation rolling. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.